All of us have been given this wonderful gift of love. Nobody teaches love. Nobody teaches who to love, how to love, the consequences of love. There's no teacher, there's no trainer. Still, everybody knows how to love. Not only human beings, even animals, birds, plants, they also love. This emotion of love is so common in the all of creation, in the whole of creation. The whole creation, it lives on love. It thrives on love. And if love is that powerful, sometimes we feel that I'm not getting enough love. And this feeling that I'm not getting enough love slowly raises a question. The question that comes on our mind is, does true love exist? This is a very, very romantic question. I can see that the youngsters are asking this question to each other. Does true love ever exist? Now, one more question that I think we need to ask ourselves is, are we expecting true love from someone else, or are we trying to give true love to someone else? Are we giving love or receiving love? If I am talking in terms of receiving true love, then I can tell you that true love does not exist in life. Because when you are trying to receive love, when you are expecting that someone should love you, when you are on the receiving end, your very mind creates that impurity in the love. Your expectations create that impurities. Your expectations create that barrier in love. And you will never experience true love in life if you think that love is something that you are receiving. But on the other hand, if you think that love is something that is possible from your side, love is something that you can do, that you can fill up with, instead of expecting it from someone else, you can give it, you can give love to other people, you can give love to friends, to family, then probably true love exists. And how do we experience this true love? When we give love, when we start giving love, the natural result is we start experiencing it. All good qualities in our life, we experience them only when we are giving. For example, a smile, we experience only when we are giving. So when somebody else is giving us a smile, it becomes very difficult for us to experience a smile. The other person will experience it much more than I am. The one who is giving a smile will experience it. Similar is the case with love. Similar is the case with good words. If I am giving good words to someone, then I can experience them, because I can experience the source of good words. I can experience the source of love when I am giving love. So instead of expecting love, if I am giving love, if I am leaving love, if I am feeling love, and I am trying to be as loving as possible in any situation, in any circumstances, with anyone, then slowly that reservoir of love within me starts getting activated. And this is true love. True love exists in every heart. But as we were saying, this true love can be experienced only by someone who is giving it, not by someone who is receiving it. Now, I don't see any condition. I don't see any reason why I should be loving someone, why I should be loving a particular situation. Instead of seeking reasons, instead of seeking excuses, I simply start feeling that love. I start giving that love. I start doing small acts of love, small acts of service, small acts of joy. I start feeling that love within myself. And once I start feeling that love, that warmth of love, I have understood the whole science of love. I have understood that it grows when I give. And with this, I start giving more love. And what happens, you know, when I'm giving love, the one who is closest to me will receive it the most. And who is the closest to me? I myself am the closest to me. When I'm giving love, it's me who will experience it much more than anyone else will. Other people will also feel that vibration, will feel that vibe. But before other people start feeling that vibe, I myself will be feeling it because I am closest to myself. When I go into a love mode, when I start becoming very loving, becoming caring, when I start becoming of service to other people, this love starts growing in me. And one day I find that it is flooding like anything. It becomes so immense, it becomes so powerful, it overwhelms me, it takes me over. And when it overwhelms me, I can experience the true love. Once I experience true love, I know that I can increase it now because there is no limit. Why should I love only my family? The whole world becomes my family. And one day the universe becomes my family. One day the cosmos can become my family. This is not philosophy. This is something that happens if we start giving love. But to a person who knows love only in receiving it from someone else, then this becomes a philosophy, this becomes an ideal, this becomes something that is not attainable. So true love exists, but it exists for true people. It exists for people who are true to their heart. It exists for people who can give love, who can share love, who can create that ambience of love, who can create that environment of love. And it exists for people who don't care with what is happening around, who are there to spread love, who are there to spread joy all over. And for such people, true love really exists.